What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today we are creating custom packages with PDQ Connect. So let's get right into it. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is log into your PDQ Connect portal, and we're going to just basically click on packages, which is located on the left-hand side. And these are all the packages that you get off the bat. Out of the box, it's a lot of them. Let's say within your company, you have a software that you guys customized, you created, you developed, you packaged it up, and you want to deploy it to your devices within your 9-to-5 job. So on the upper right-hand side, you have a button that says create package. Let's click on that, and it takes you here. First thing that we need to do is customize our properties. Once you customize the name, the version, a description, as well as a timeout, on your left-hand side, you have a add install step. If you click on that little arrow to expand it as a drop-down menu, you have a bunch of steps that you are able to add to your package. Let's go over each one by one. So we are going to select add install step, and this is what we need to do within this particular step. Now, by default, this is the one that you definitely need because this is where you upload your MSI, MSU, MSP, and your EXE file into. You are able to add the parameters here, a success code, and on the run as section, if you click on the drop-down menu, you only have two types, either local system or logged on user. I would think most of the time you do a local system. And for the error mode, you only have these three options. So on the left-hand side, let's click on add PowerShell step. And this is what you have for the PowerShell step. Pretty simple, pretty self-explanatory. If your package needs PowerShell to run or to activate or do whatever, this is where you do it here. The run as is the same options, and the error mode is the same, just like the install step. Another step is the file copy. If your package needs to copy a particular file to the device, this is where you do it here. If the file is already there, make sure that you click on overwrite existing files, but it's pretty self-explanatory of the steps that you need to do here for the file copy. The next step is a reboot. If the software that you're installing needs a reboot once it's complete, most likely this is what you need to do. Now, one of the steps is nested packages, and this is pretty cool because if you have a software that you're deploying to your devices that need dependencies to be installed first, this is where you would do it. And that's it, guys. That is how we create a custom package within PDQ Connect. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.